Jude Lazon, President of the Belize Softball Federation. Our Belizean softball community was saddened to learn of the recent passing of our International Softball Hall of Famer, Raymond Granville Lashley. In his honor, a few of his friends, acquaintances, colleagues, and past players have collaborated to share some of the special memories of this unforgettable softball icon. Thanks for joining us.
I've had the pleasure of knowing and working with Raymond Granville Lashley for a number of years. Raymond was a great character. He was a round-run Belize, won all the regional medals at the Central American Games and Pan American Games. Raymond was always helpful to everyone in the softball field. I'd like to extend my sympathies to his wife, Greta, his son, Raymond, his daughter, Deidre, and the grandkids.
Good afternoon. Special memories of my association with Raymond Granville Lashley, softball stalwart, coach, and Hall of Famer. My joys begin when, as a player in 1974, we won the first gold medal for Belize. Joys were continued when in 1978, I was able to participate in the first World Series in softball in El Salvador. And later on, when in my capacity as the president of the Belize Softball Federation, I was able to enjoy the privilege and the joy of getting Raymond Granville Lashley elected into the International Softball Hall of Fame in 1997. Sleep on, my brother, and well done, member of our softball family. Rest in peace.
I am Linda Lewis Brown. I would like to express my sincere condolences to the Lashley family. I have lost a great coach and even more a dear friend. Mr. Lashley always expected 100% from all his players. He expected us to report to practice and games on time and expected the very best at all times. Thank you, Mr. Lashley, for instilling in me all these values that I have carried with me throughout my career and life. Mr. Lashley, you will be surely missed.
Hi, my name is Margaret Usher. First of all, I would like to send my condolences to Mrs. Lashley and the Lashley family on the passing of Mr. Lashley. Growing up, I've always heard of Mr. Lashley, but I've never really got to meet him until I started playing senior softball in 1975. In 1976, I got selected to the Belize national team, where he was the manager, and he managed my career for at least 8 years. Mr. Lashley was a genuine person. He was a genuine manager. If he believes in you, nothing can change that unless it's you. I remember one time when we were in Venezuela, I had a hard time hitting the ball. I was the only one on the team not getting on the bases. So I asked him, right before a game, if I could have a designated hitter. He looked me right in my eyes and said to me, "Am I managing this team or you are?" So from that day on, I learned whatever I'm thinking, I keep my mouth closed. Mr. Lashley had so much faith in his players. You would have to do a whole lot for him to take you out of a game because he believed in you. And nothing that you do or say would let him think otherwise. No matter what a bad day you were having or what a bad game you were having, and you know you had a bad game, he would let you feel that you had done well. And I just want to say, Mr. Lashley, your memory and your legacy will live on forever. Every time softball come up, your name be right up there with the other legends that had passed on. So I just want to say, may God bless your soul. Live on, sleep on, in peace. Mrs. Lashley, I pray that the good Lord would give you the strength to see you through this rough time. Thank you.
I'd like to say a few words concerning Raymond Lashley. I had known Brother Lash as that's the way I call him, Brother Lash. I'd known him from we were in Wesley School, then into Technical High School. We remained friends, but we went our different way. He stayed in Belize and I came up to Cairo. But we still used to keep in contact with each other. Brother Lash was in the softball world, and coming up here, I placed myself in the softball world also. And we would coordinate each other with what we were doing, and we would rely on each other to get feedback from each other concerning the game. He used to travel up to in Quick Care to look for me, and I would go down to Belize to look for him, and we shared some wonderful times. But our best interest was in softball. When I was manager of the under 19 team for 7 years, he would always list and we'd go over our practice routine and get things going. He'd tell me about what he used to do when they were training the national female team. And from there on, I would just, well, let's say, copy something from him and get things going this side. Lashley was a very, very, very good friend of mine. We were like brothers.
Hello, this is Dorit Martinez, one of Belize's softball players in the 80s and the 90s. First baseman for Berger 303 softball under Raymond Lashley, and also as a left fielder for the All Belize National Softball Team under Raymond Lashley. I would like to take this time to express my sincere sadness and condolences to Mrs. Guido Lashley and to the entire Lashley family. Our country has lost a great icon, a hero, and patriot, and more. Mr. Lashley has served his country with honor. He loved so many sports, but his love for women's softball was his greatest pleasure. His role as a coach for the local teams and also for the national women's softball team helped propel Belize to many victories and place our country's name to be the best amongst our competitors in the world. His coaching style was one that challenged players to be disciplined and to strive for excellence. And yes, we were punished many a times when we did not perform to our standards and expectation. Mr. Lashley will always be remembered as a coach and a manager who was able to realize his players' potentials, strengths and weaknesses, and use them at the right time to attain his glory. For that, we must thank him and remember him forever, a true icon. May his soul rest in eternal peace.
Balash was never afraid to speak his mind. In fact, some would say there was no license on his mouth. But we respected him for it. From very early on, out of all her daughters, he took a very special liking to our third daughter, hearing. Maybe it was the way she embraced the softball community. Her perseverance at improving her skills at the game and for doing things her way. Which led him to remark, "This, that he won." Later on, after seeing Kiri play high school softball and play on the U19 national team, he turned to Delcy, herself a gold, silver, and bronze medalist, and told her with his classic Palash side look, "This one won better than you. Whoa." Rest in peace, my friend. Rest assured, you will never be forgotten.
This is Cynthia Casey. So many special memories of Mr. Raymond Lashley. One that always comes to my mind is one time when he told me, "You know what? I can't stand you a bit personally, but when it comes to playing softball, you will always be at first base for me." That was so funny, but yet very sincere. Rest in peace, Mr. Lashley.
I am Belizean. I have many fond memories of Mr. Lashley as a manager, a coach, and an executive of the Federation. One of my most memorable moments was in San Juan, Puerto Rico, 1979 at the Pan American Games, Belize versus the United States of America. I can vividly recall him cheering us on at each half inning. "Come on, ladies, you can do it. Come on, ladies, you can do it." This is like David and Goliath, you know. Want to remember that story there? Just imagine that you are playing ball at Rogers Stadium. "Come on, we can do it." You all know what happened to Goliath, right? That's exactly the type of manager Mr. Lashley was. Motivational manager, even in his own unorthodox way. Rest in peace, Mr. Lash. Rest in peace.
Hi, I'm Bernie D. McDougall. I want to take this opportunity to send my heartfelt condolences to Mrs. Lashley and the entire Lashley family on the passing of Mr. Lash. I remember coming back to the game after being away for about a year or so after I had my son. The first person I ran into at the gates of Rogers Stadium was Mr. Lash, and he said to me, "Oh, you're back. Now, I'm not scared of you in the bases anymore. You already got slowed down. You had a baby. You're washed up." And I remember thinking, why would he say that to me? I was kind of upset. But I took that and I ran with that. And I would be at Rogers Stadium like an hour or so before practices, getting myself into shape. Days that we didn't have practices, I was at the National Stadium at the horse track, just running, jogging, getting myself into shape. That year, I won stolen bases and I won RBIs. Later that year, I remember Mr. Lash coming to me and he said, "You think I forgot what I said to you? That was intentional." And he said that while I knew that you may use that motivation and use it to beat me during the city competition. I also know that that was a win for Belize because I know you, and I know that you would take that to heart. And that was my way of making you work hard. But that was Mr. Lash, very unselfish, very unorthodox. I remember seeing that written down somewhere. Somebody said that he was the unorthodox one. And I said, yes. And that was a lesson I took from him that I carried into my everyday life. Look at the big picture. Be unselfish. Belize has lost a good one. Rest in peace, Mr. Lash.
I would like to express my deepest condolences to Mrs. Lashley and her entire family, and also to the BTL softball team on the loss of Mr. Lashley, or affectionately known to us, who has the honor of him coaching us, Palash. I have known Mr. Lashley for quite some years. I had always been selected by him whenever BTL wins the nationals in Belize City to go and represent Belize in our Central American region. Again, my deepest condolences to Miss Lashley and her entire family and the BTL softball family. Rest in peace, Mr. Lash.
I am Beulah Gillette, and I would like to express my heartfelt sympathy and condolences to Mrs. Gretel Lashley and the entire Lashley family of the passing of our legendary softball manager, Mr. Raymond Lashley. I played shortstop for the Belize national team, and I must say, it was an honor to have been coached by such a great icon. Mr. Lashley was a brilliant manager, and he had the mindset of a winner and expected nothing but perfection from the players he chose for the Belize national team. Mr. Lashley, you will be remembered for decades to come. You will surely be missed. Rest in peace, Mr. Lash.
This goes out to Mrs. Lashley and family. I am Doyle Morales, former softball player of Millport, Greenstripe, Guinness, and Belican, wishing you and your family strength and comfort through this difficult time. Words fail to express my deepest sorrow for your loss. However, my heart goes out to you and your family on the loss of the legendary Coach Raymond Lashley. God called him home to rest, and may God turn your time of darkness into light again. He is gone, but he will definitely not be forgotten. May Coach Raymond Lashley rest in eternal peace.
Hi, this is Elaine Smith-Proby, sending my condolences to the Lashley family. I was one of Raymond Lashley softball pitcher from his team, Berger 303. And of course, he was the reason why I was able to make it to the Olympic team. And he was so instrumental with his style, with his tenacity, with the way he pushes you to reach the max of your full capacity. And that was the reason why it allows me to get on the main team to be able to go to the Olympics. And one of the coaches of that team, of course, that was responsible for us to win the gold and bring back the first gold medal to Belize. I want to just really send out my deepest condolences to the family. And even though his work on earth is done, he's gone, he will never be forgotten. And we love you dearly, and we love the family. Okay, so take care, love, and strength to all.
I am Floyd Flores. I once was an assistant coach under Mr. Raymond Lashley for more than 10 years. One of my best moments I share with Mr. Lashley was when we won the gold medal in Guatemala City in 2004. I believe that is our greatest achievement together as coaches. There is so much more I could say about him, but I will end here and say rest in peace, Mr. Lashley.
I'm Kiri Lazama, former outfielder for Team DJ. I grew up around softball and have many memories of Mr. Lashley offering advice on how to improve on the field, and also many memories of him expressing disappointment whenever he saw me playing any position other than outfield. He always insisted, "You're a natural born outfielder." When I was a teenager, my mother played for Team BTL, and so as an adult, when I moved to Team DJ, it really felt like returning home. I was really lucky that the team he created was still together for me to be a part of. His death marks the end of an era in Belize softball, but I'm sure that his legacy will continue to endure. May he rest in peace.